this that I haven't showed just yet that I know of. And I covered this dirt hole up. Just gonna put a new one in. And this one has been destroyed by coyotes. This property has. They've been outsmarting my sets. This is gonna be another simple dirt hole I do. Now I'm gonna put a natural guide there. Here's my trap bed. I'm gonna dig it out just a little bit where I can get down in it, do some work. I'm gonna make sure this trap center right here. I'm gonna put a new dirt hole, more or less just right here. Same distance as the other one. We're gonna make it stand out. I'm on the coyote's main trail they've been taking. This set has been worked like crazy. It's been set off so many different times. It was set off again today. Deer might have stepped in it today, but my dirt hole has been worked. So I'm gonna head up this new thing of salt. Currently, February 1st, 2022, and it's 50 degrees outside. We went from complete snow and ice to complete warm weather for this time of year. Kind of crazy if you ask me. I'm gonna get the salt open. So I'm gonna go ahead and sprinkle some salt down the bottom. Leave it open. Put my glove right back on. So by doing this, get some peat moss, layer it down the bottom here, just like so. I'm gonna make sure I line this trap up more with this side. I'm gonna put my dirt hole here. So I'm gonna go ahead and set this trap, get it fitted out. Set. Make sure all this lays down in here. I'm gonna do some work, it looks like, on this side by packing down more. I'm gonna set this trap more in an angle, get away from this dirt hole. It's gonna be more or less facing this way. So I'm gonna go ahead and sprinkle some salt and get the pack. Good thing about salt is, keeps your traps from freezing. It's kept mine from freezing all winter, unless you have a little bit of freezing rain and it gets on top of your sifted dirt. It makes it hard for it to stay dry in that sense. Make sure it's getting down in. Make sure I pack it all the way around. Make sure I pack it up here. You want this stuff packed tight where your trap isn't going to move. I'm layering a good bit of salt on. Okay, because it still gets down in the cold weather, below freezing at nighttime. You know, we're having some warmer weather here. So I'm just going to keep packing around the trap here. Okay, just keep packing it. Keep that clean as possible. Packing around. Whatever I gotta do, keep it steady. Still gotta work on that jaw on this one side. Layer some more salt on. All the way around the trap pan. I'm just gonna keep working it until it's all packed down in with no problem with it moving all the way around. Keep packing it. still having some wiggle on this one jaw. Once I get plenty enough pack, shouldn't have a problem out of it. That's the only thing you don't want to happen, has trap movement. Caddy feels it, he'll dig it up, flip it over, or he'll just say he don't even want to mess with it, he'll walk off. Because something seems odd and out of the ordinary to that coyote or animal that you're trying to catch. Keep that pan clean, without putting pressure. And keep putting pressure all the way around it. This side, spread some of this out. Everything's looking mighty fine now. So, by doing that, just don't feel it. Make sure it all looks good. That guy from underneath the trap pan. Okie dokie. Make sure everything's looking good.
Another fine layer. Salt.
Take some more. Put some more on. Make sure it all looks good. Scrape that on the top. We have another 27 days left of land trapping. And I'll be going back more water trapping right after. Keeping some videos coming out.
I've been working, having troubles getting videos for now.
I plan to keep on going. Sure, all that's nice and packed down. Let's move all the way around.
Another fine layer.
Just sprinkle some more around. That's all I'm going to do. Sprinkle it around, make it look nice. Making a bigger area in case I get some tracks in the bed, I can tell what it is.
One more small little layer
around this part. Then I'm gonna get all that on off the top of the pan.
Sprinkle some more salt on top of the pan. Sprinkle some all the way around. I'm gonna get a sifter and sift some stuff out.
Now all I'm going to do is, I'm going to get some of this dirt off this bank side. Some nice dirt. Break all the nice chunks off. Whatever you get.
Oh, that's a blooper. I got me some dirt.
Gonna walk over. I'm just gonna sit that on top. Nice big area. make it all blend. Chuck the rest. Now, all I need to do is bake the set and also dig out a dirt hole before I do that. So making the dirt hole, trap pan's right there, and we'll come back in right about here. Twist down, twist, do all the way through as much as I can get out. We still got some hard dirt down underneath, makes it a little harder for digging. Do some twisting, check it out. Get all the dirt out of it. Now what I'm gonna do is go ahead and take this. I'm gonna beat it down into the back. Get a few twists. Make sure that's on an angle. You want your predators coming up and seeing your bait in the hole. So what I'm gonna do now is, how where my trap pan is, versus in my dirt hole, 10 inches. And now, take my baiting gloves off. Get out of bait that I caught my first coyote on. Capital punishment. Lid on the bottom. And now, I just need to find a tiny stick here. About like yay so, like that. Don't want one too big. I'm just gonna take plenty. Ease it over to the set. I'm just gonna drop down in. As far as my hand can get it. Lid back on really quick. Take that longer stick I found. Push it back in there on that angle. Can't see it. Now, we're gonna take out some new urine I haven't used in this area. Try some bobcat urine, trap shed. I put in some little bottles, make it easier to carry around. By doing that, put that combination right there. Now another one I used, along with that on my other set that I caught my first coyote on, it's some Minnesota Red. It's a weird combination. Combination worked on a property from here around, I'd say around 4 miles from this location. A little bit of a difference, not too much. But you got Cabin's Minnesota Red. So I'm gonna crack it open. Look for another stick. See if I can break this part off. Once I did that, take me a good amount. I'm gonna put it right there by that backing. Now by doing that, last step, take some sheep's wool. Put on a stick here. I'm gonna make it look like something's nice down here in the bottom of this hole. where they can at least see a little bit of it. They can't see all of it. And I'm just going to put that stick right there with it.
Or they won't just go for the stick when it's out.
Another option you can do
is just put it right there. There's another dirt hole set tutorial from me. I'll give you all update on the set once we catch. I'll see y'all in the next one.